InshaAllah, as usual, every Saturday we have the Fiqh class or the Fiqh Halaqah, continuing what we started before, still talking about the rules of the Salah. Last week, we were discussing the prayer times. Yani, a question that I asked at the beginning of the Halaqah last week. Allah, I need from the brothers, if you can come a little bit forward, that would be good, inshallah. If you can come forward, I'll appreciate it for you, inshallah. Jazakumullah. Because they said it halaqah. You know that? You guys remember this hadith? Allah, if it's not going to be boring, we should start everything with this hadith. This hadith is amazing. It will make you attend any halaqah, any education, lesson, anything that gets you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith will, if you remember it, all the time will be there. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam fi baytin min biyutillah. When some people get together, gather together in a masjid, like that, that's exactly the situation. يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَيَتَدَرَّسُونَهُ فِي مَا بَيْنَهُمْ. Then why are we here? Why we are talking now? Getting the rules from the Quran, from the Sunnah, and trying to teach one another, learn from one another. إِلَّا حَفَّتْهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ. The angels will circle them, will surround them. وَنَزَلَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ سَكِينَةِ وَغَشِيَتْهُمُ الرَّحْمَةِ. So the tranquility will be they will feel all this tranquility, all of them, they will feel the tranquility. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will shower them with His mercy. وَذَكَرَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَنْ عِنْدِ. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will mention you with your name to the angels. Ahmad, the son of so-and-so, Muhammad, the son of so-and-so, Amin, the son, Mahmoud, the son of so-and-so. He attended that halaqah intentionally or sincerely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that's why I like it. I like this way. When we get closer, yani inshallah, we get the mercy from one another, inshallah ta'ala. Last week, we mentioned, I started off with this hadith. With this question, sorry. Why we pray the five times at these times, not in a different times? Yani, why we don't pray Fajr at 10? Or Zuhr at at the end of the day, nobody knows. Why specifically these times, part of the day? Who remembers? Ibn al-Hadith, I need the Hadith. Yes, but there is another Hadith explaining that. It's not pray as you saw me praying. So what is the way that he was taught, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to pray? Who remembers the Hadith? Yeah, as much as you can. You don't have to, it's not a quiz.
A summary of the hadith.
Yeah, summary of the hadith. The way, what you got out of the hadith. I will be, even in Bangladeshi language, I'm okay. So this brother, Jazallah Khair, starts with Zuhr, which is the first prayer of the day.
No, okay. But the hadith starts with Zuhr.
But the hadith starts with the Zuhr, by the way. Okay. طيب, Ahmad Ali. So basically what happened, and this is your answer, should be your answer. And I recommend you to go and memorize the hadith. It's just 4 or 5 lines, it's not a big deal. To memorize it in Arabic or in English, or in even your language. Because if somebody asks you that question, you're going to be ready to answer. Because the Prophet ﷺ said that he was led in prayer by Jibreel alayhi salam. And he showed him the ways and the times, the exact times of the five prayers on a daily basis. And he gave him that he prayed with them the first day at the beginning of the time and at the end of the time. And he told him in between, this is your time. For example, Salat al-Fajr, from the dawn until the sun rises. So you can pray until the sun rises, right before the sun rises. Salat al-Dhuhr, when the time of that zawal, which is the sun reaches its zenith, until the shade of the person becomes as high as you. And in another opinion, as twice as you, which is a time fast. Then the time fast from that time until right before the sun gets yellow, or right before the sun rises, according to another opinion, then the time for Maghrib, the only difference that the time of Maghrib doesn't have this, you need, I would say, that Jibreel alayhi salam led the Prophet in that hadith at one time, both days, but in a different hadith, to be precise, he led him, or he showed him that even Maghrib has the gap or the window between the beginning and the end of the time, and then the Isha, the same. So please go, and as I said at the beginning, for Seerah and for Fiqh, we cannot say everything. And I cannot for sure, I don't know everything at the end of the day. I skip a lot, and I not ignore, but I forget a lot. But your goal and your duty is to go and to educate yourself, and to go home. Yahi, we're talking about prayer. Imagine prayer, that you and I have to pray at least 5 times a day. 5 times in different times. At least 17 rak'ah a day, right? On a daily basis. And we still have problems with that. Not only you, your family. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul fi surah Taha, wa'mur ahlaka bi-salaqati. So order not only you go to your family too, and you teach your wife and you teach your kids. But if I don't have the knowledge, I'm not going to be able to, my wife prays wrong or she makes mistake in her prayer, I'm not going to be able to correct that because I don't know. Okay, so please pay attention to that. And once we mention a topic, go and educate yourself. Give yourself half an hour a week and educate yourself, get authentic sources and read about it. Okay, today, 2 main questions. I'm going to start off the topic of today's talk with 2 questions. The first one is, ما هي الأوقات التي تكره فيها الصلاة أو التي نهينا عن الصلاة فيها? What are the parts of the day in which it is disliked to pray? And the And number 2, what are the places in which we cannot pray? ما هي الأماكن التي لا نصلي فيها? Okay, طيب. Let's go to the first question. Who knows the answer for the first question? قول يا حبيبي.
السؤال الأول اللي هو وقت الشروق اللي هو دفاع رمح قدر رمح.
لا الشروق مالوش دعوة بالرمح دلوقتي.
والسؤال الثاني اللي هو أثناء غروب الشمس.
ماشي غروب الشمس
اللي هو عند الغروب
طيب ماشي طيب ماشي جزاك الله خير جود فيري جود اتفضل يا ابراهيم
دخول وقت
اي
شروق الشمس
ماشي ممتاز
والقرنين هي في شروق الشمس
ايوه القرنين في شروق الشمس انا هاخد الكلام باخد باخد كل حاجه وهصحح بعدين I'm just taking everything then I'm gonna correct I didn't correct him yet I don't want to make him feel, Sheikh is correcting me in public, so I'm going to leave the class.
It's okay, half the people here don't understand what we're saying.
Alhamdulillah, but still half, the other half knows. So I don't want to be in trouble with him. Bashir is close, Ahmed was close, that there are... Fadriya.
There's a third one.
Actually, there are 5 times. Yep, zapt. 5 times. In which we shouldn't pray, or it is disliked to pray in. But whether it is forbidden, or just makruh, or haram, what's the ruling, we'll explain that. But I'll take them in 2 parts. There are 2 times, they're relevant to the prayer, your prayer, not the time itself. That your prayer, it's not permissible at that time, not the time itself. This type of prayer is not permissible at that time. Other prayer are. We'll explain it. فيقول لك أول وقتين يا فيصل قلت حاجة غلط ولا حاجة؟ جاي شكلك كده جاي كده. I feel that you are from the security come check on us. حبيبي يا فيصل.
كلها صحيح.
جزاك الله خير. طيب. Like bayanat al-ahadith, the authentic ahadith told us that there are five times in which we shouldn't pray. Two of them relevant to your prayer, this specific prayer is not permissible at that time. These two times are after Salat al-Fajr until the sun rises. After Salat al-Asr until the sun gets yellow. So these two times, you shouldn't pray the sunnah in. Yani not all the sunnah, but yani you shouldn't initiate prayer in this time. Then somebody, you came, you wake up after Salat al-Fajr. Sorry, you prayed Fajr. You prayed the sunnah before Salat al-Fajr, and you prayed Fajr. Khalas. You shouldn't pray anything else until the sun rises, and then you wait for at least 10 to 15 minutes, and you pray the sunnah after that.
Yeah, sure. 10, 15 minutes in Egypt, not here.
Yeah, not here.
Here it takes a lot longer. For
longer?
Oh yeah. The closer you are to the equator, the faster the sun rises.
Okay.
So here we're very in a high latitude.
Yeah, but,
so it takes,
but the sun rises already.
Yeah, but between the time of the shuruq on the timetable and the time when the sun is high enough for us to pray,
okay,
the 10-15 minutes doesn't apply
okay.
in the high latitude.
Okay, we'll talk about it when we come to this specific point. So here is after Salat al-Fajr until the sun rises, and after Salat al-Asr until the sun gets yellow, you shouldn't pray any sunnah. However, what about if I didn't pray my Fajr, Asla? Like I woke up right before sunrise, what should I do?
Pray right away.
I will pray right away. What about if I prayed the Fajr, I came and the Imam is leading Salat al-Fajr. So I didn't pray my sunnah, the before Fajr sunnah. What should I do?
Pray after shuruq.
After shuruq, it's the Malik.
First.
Yeah, it's you can pray after Fajr right away. Still an opinion, yeah. But you still can pray.
But there's a hadith.
Yeah, yeah, there's two hadith in this area. And two riwayat. I'll mention all of them.
I'll
explain all of that. I have all of that, inshallah. فَإِنْ صَلَّى الْفَجْرَ يُكْرَهُ لَهُ أَنْ يُصَلِّي صَلَاةَ نَافِلَةً حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسِ ويجوز له ذلك قبل أن يصلي الفجر. طيب. Somebody, think with me. I woke up after they prayed Fajr in the masjid, but before the sun rises. Can I pray the sunnah before or not?
Can you repeat that?
Yani I'm coming to pray Fajr.
At the mosque.
The brothers, I looked at the time, I was wrong. 15 minutes later, I came, everybody's done, they left. Can I pray the sunnah before, or I just pray Fajr only?
Pray the sunnah, then pray Fajr.
Yeah, you still can pray. Well, why it is the time that if I pray the Fajr, I cannot pray sunnah. But I can pray the sunnah at that time. Before Salat al-Fajr. Then I pray Salat al-Fajr. Even other people, they already finished their Fajr and their sunnah and everything. And they went back to sleep. But to me, I still have the fard time, which is the time for Salat al-Fajr, and I can pray the sunnah before that. That's number one. The same applies to Salat al-Asr. I prayed Asr. People prayed Asr and I came to the masjid late. The sun, it's closer to get yellow. Can I pray the sunnah, Tahiyyat al-Masjid, Bethlehem, before the Salat al-Asr or not? I can do that, and I prayed Salat al-Asr, and to me, it's different from other people who already finished their prayer, and it's not permissible for them to pray at that time. So that's why this is relevant to somebody's prayer, specific prayer, not to everybody. Okay? These are the two times that attached to a certain prayer, which is a nafila. Salat al-Nafila. Brothers who speak English only. You know nafila, what does it mean? Nafila.
Optional.
Yes, optional. Optional. Prayer. Nafil. It's tatawwa. Okay? Sunnah. Yani it goes all of this, inshallah ta'ala. Tayyib. But however, this is the point that I mentioned earlier. This applies to all the sunnah. them except after Salat al-Fajr for the 2 rak'at for Fajr. And I came, I just mentioned earlier, let me confirm that again. I came, the Imam is leading the Salat. What should I do? Some people, they made a mistake here. The Imam is leading the Salat and the Jama'ah is on and he's praying his Sunnah. Have you seen that before?
Yes.
Seen a lot. It happens a lot. Yani him, in his mind, you know, it's Sheikh Sherif for sure in Salat al-Fajr. He takes his time. Some people, they still are yani, asking me about this. Yani, but it's Salat al-Fajr. Yani, if we don't read Quran in Salat al-Fajr, when are we going to read Quran? And Sheikh Sherif is fast in Salat al-Dhuhr and Salat al-Asr. That's Sulaiman complaining. Because after Salat al-Dhuhr, you want to go get your lunch, and after Salat al-Asr, you want to go get some nap and stuff. So I have mercy on you guys. Anyway, for the Imam is leading the Salah, and you enter the masjid, and you pray the Sunnah. No, you cannot do that. إذا أقيمت الصلاة فلا صلاة إلا المكتوبة. When the Imam is leading the Salah, I join the Salah. But this is for Fajr, ya Sheikh, and the Sunnah for Fajr is before, not after. We're saying it is permissible for you to pray that Sunnah after. After Salatul Fajr. The 2 rak'at for Fajr. However, there is another opinion saying that, hold on, you prayed Salatul Fajr? Good. Imam Hanifa said that it's haram to pray in this time. You know what? What you do? And Imam Malik too. So what you do? You wait until the sun rises and you wait for that time. We say 10 minutes, 15 minutes for Amin. It might be half an hour until the time of between the shuruq and the sun goes high.
Qadr Rumhi.
Rumhi. So, and then you pray your sunnah. But I would say, I would recommend you to pray your sunnah right after, because after that, you might have to go to work, you might have to go back to sleep to be able to function the whole day. You still can do that right away. And this is the act of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu. This is not like our opinion here. يعني روي عن ابن عمر أنه كان يقول ذلك. Okay, طيب. There is some opinion that if you الحنابلة, they said that to pray in these two times it's forbidden, it's haram for them. كما أن محرم في باقي الأوقات, and this is another يعني their opinion. طيب. In addition to these two times, I have another 3 times. This is the time itself, not your prayer. It's haram to pray and speak to Fadr Amin.
No, you said Hanabila say it's haram, Hanafi say it's haram, Imam Malik says
Imam Shafi'i al-Ra'i gamil giddam.
So 3 opinions say it's haram, only Imam Shafi'i says it's okay.
No. Al-Malikiyya wa Abu Hanifa, no, Hanabila they said haram.
You said Abu Hanifa says it's
haram. Wa Abu Hanifa. We'll get it. Maybe I meant Hanabila when I said Abu Hanifa. But Abu Hanifa, for him, it's manhiyun anhu, which is not that haram. Yeah. But I'll emphasize it inshallah. For the other 3 times, he'll like, عند طلوع الشمس حتى ترتفع إلى ما يعادل 3 أمتار. This is what Ahmed says. Like when the sun rises, right at the sunrise, I cannot pray. No way to pray at that time. Except you started your Fajr and the sun rises while you pray, that's something else. Number one. Number two, وَتَذْهَبُ حُمْرَةُ الشَّمْسُ وَلَا يَزِيدْ زَمَنُهُ عَنْ رُبْعِ سَعَةٍ. That's in moderate circumstances, we're talking about 10 to 15 minutes. The point that Amin raised earlier, that in our situation over here can be more than this. But the sun rises, I cannot pray, I'll wait for at least 15 minutes like Amin said. At least. وَعِنَّ اسْتِوَاءِ الشَّمْسِ. Here is the time of the zawab. You know when the sun, that this is the time right before Salat al-Dhuhr. Yeah, between the sun rises, after that 15 minutes, you still can pray, and this is actually the time of Salat al-Dhuhr. Until the time when the sun is like that. It doesn't happen here, by the way. When the sun has reached the zenith, like there is no shade at all. And then you wait, قدر المحيل, as Ahmed said, جهة الغرب حتى تميل إلى جهة الغرب ويبدأ الظل إلى الزحف أو في الزحف إلى جهة الشرق ولا يزيد زمنه على ثلث ساعة. So at the time of the zawal, again, you wait 20 minutes and then you can pray. And here is the time until after Salat Asr. Again, the time of the sunset. Well, this is the between the sun gets yellow until the sunset. This is another time that you cannot pray in. And I'm sorry, this is a little bit, today's topic is a little bit dry and solid. So I want to get somebody to remind me and to say the five times again. Please. Tfadl, ma'alish,
shan narakkiz kama ma. I heard Imam Abu Hanifa saying still you can pray Asr between that time.
Which is?
From it becomes yellow until it sets.
Yeah, you have to, we will explain that. If you can, if you have to make up for the prayer, you still can pray. Even in any time.
Make up is like one qada and one is the one that it's right away, it's Asr, it's not Maghrib yet.
No. If you were with us last week, after Isfirar Shams, when the sun gets yellow, you are praying Qadha not at the time. The time is gone. It's passed. The time of Asr is already passed. There is hadith about this, that do not pray Asr when the sun, or do not delay Asr until the sun gets yellow. At Isfirar Shams, Allah. Okay? Time. Anybody can, can you recall them again, the five times?
So, between the time we pray Fajr until sunrise, between the time we pray Asr until the sun becomes yellow,
okay.
And then between the time of the sunrise until it's two spears, the sun is high by two spears, between the time the sun is at its zenith until the time it starts going down towards the west, between the time the sun is yellow until
sunset,
until
Maghrib. Details comes as follows, because I understand this very well, that we come from different backgrounds. We have some Shafi'i, some Hanabila, and I said at the beginning, I'm not going to go into details, big time about the different opinions, but here we need to elaborate a little bit. The Imam Abu Hanifa, ذهب الأحناف إلى أن الصلاة في هذه الأوقات محرمة, as I said earlier, سواء كانت فرضا أم نفلا, وأنها باطلة لا تنعقد. So, first thing, واستثنوا العصر, like you said, the only exception, they said that the prayer in these times, that's the opinion of Abu Hanifa. Prayers in these times, whether it is fard or nafl, it's not even acceptable. It's not valid. Except for Asr. Because they said that it's من أدرك العصر من العصر ركعة من العصر. Listen, قبل أن تغرب الشمس فقد أدرك العصر. There is a hadith saying that, and this is another opinion to be honest with you, that whoever catch one rak'ah right before Maghrib, his Asr is valid, and he prayed Asr on time, like you said. So you're right. But there is another opinion saying that it's until the sun gets yellow. But here is Abu Hanifa said that in these five times, it's forbidden to pray except for us. Okay? طيب. الحنابلة قالوا إن صلاة النافلة تحرم في هذه الأوقات ويجوز فيها قضاء الفوائد وصلاة الجنازة. So the Hanbali school, they said that it's, we're talking only about the Nafila, about the Sunnah. But if you missed a prayer, you have to, or you should make up for the prayer. You can actually make up for the prayer at that time. If you missed, there is not a janazah, you can pray at that time. So we're talking only about the nawafil. This is the opinion of the Hanafi school. وَعَدَدْ صَلَاةِ صَلَاةِ بَيْتِ Okay. وَهَكَذَا أَجَادَ أَوْمِنَهَا And one of these things is to pray salat, sunnat al-fajr, after salat al-fajr. So you can do that. Al-Malikiyya said that it's haram to pray salat al-tatawwu' in these times, وَقْتَ طُلُوعِ الشَّمْسِ وَقْتَ غُرُوبِهَا وكراهتها بعد العصر إلى أن تصفر الشمس وبعد صلاة الفجر إلى أن تطلع الشمس أما صلاة الفرائض فجائزة. So the Malikiyya, they said that it's undesirable in two times only to pray the Sunnah. Sorry, it's haram to pray the Sunnah in two times. The time of sunrise and the time of sunset. And it is undesirable after Salat al-Asr until the sun gets yellow, and after Salat al-Fajr until the sun rises, as for the fara'id, still can make up for the fara'id. I'll give you an opinion. And I feel left it because your brain like twisted now. I'll give you an opinion, and I personally, I go with this. If you like it, you like it. You don't like it, it's up to you. You go and follow your madhab. This is the opinion of Imam Shafi. Imam Shafi يقول أنه أن الصلاة في هذه الأوقات مكروه. Imam Shafi يقول said it is undesirable to pray in these five times unless the prayer has a reason. I'll give you an example. Right before Salat al-Maghrib, what happens? It's a time of, you shouldn't pray, right? But when I enter the masjid, isn't a reason for me to pray, which is tahiyyat al-masjid, isn't it a reason to pray? So that's a reason. So when I pray in that time, I pray the prayer that has a reason. But I don't come and say, you know what, I'm just praying, I'm here actually in the masjid, and I prayed tahiyyat al-masjid long time ago, but you know what, I'm going to pray to raka'at. No, don't do that. Unless the prayer has a reason. Salatu istisqa, salatu al-istikhara, salatu tahiyyatul masjid. You make up for a prayer that you missed, you still can do that. Allahu a'lam, I feel more comfortable with this salat, sunnatul wudu, wa sujudu tilawa, wa sujudu shukr, wa salatul a'idi, wa al-kusuf, wa salatul janaza, wa qadaul fa'ita, wa raka'atil tawaf, فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ يَجُوزُ بِدُونِكَ رَاهَا وَمَنْ فَاتَهُ الْوِتْرِ. Even you missed your witr, and you want to make up for your witr, you still can pray the witr at that time. So this is an opinion that, you know, it makes sense to many scholars. You want to take it, it's up to you. You want to leave it, it's up to you too. فضل يا أمين.
When is it okay to pray witr? I mean, you pray fajr, then you pray witr.
Yeah. If you missed the witr, you can pray the witr when you remember it. Allahu a'lam. طيب. Why the scholars, no, nobody asked this question. And it's Amal Tuli, he keeps saying imam so-and-so, imam so-and-so. From where they got this? Well, at the end of the day, they didn't get anything from their own. Has to be an evidence, right? And by the way, if somebody gives you an opinion, like you're asking somebody about something, and he gives you his opinion, and he doesn't give you the dalil, don't take it. If there is no dalil, who might have said that? The ulama of the schools of thought, they said that if you have an authentic hadith supporting my opinion, take it. Which means if there is no hadith to support that opinion, I'm not going to take it. Absolutely. One word. And Abdullah ibn Umar, these are the evidence. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu yaqul, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا يتحرى أحدكم فيصلي عند طلوع الشمس ولا عند غروبها. So do not, Prophet ﷺ said that, do not pray at the time of the ghurub or the shuruq. Sunset, sunrise. No way. And I believe if the father is not here, what there? Sulaiman? Huh? Is playground in the back or what? La hawla wa quwwata illa billah. Sayyidina Amr ibn Absa radiallahu anhu, one of the great Sahaba, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him the following. Listen to this very well. This hadith will give you the five times. يقول قال صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا صليت الصبح فأقصر عن الصلاة حتى تطلع الشمس. When you pray Salat al-Subh, Salat al-Fajr, stop praying until the sun rises. But this is the first time that we mentioned, right? فَإِذَا طَلَعَتْ فَلَا تُصَلِّ حَتَّى تَرْتَفِعْ. Then when the sun rises, then wait until the sun gets high, which means the 15 minutes that we talk about. So these are number two. فَإِنَّهَا تَطْلُعُ بَيْنَ قَرْنَيِ الشَّيْطَانِ. The sun rises between the two horns of the shaitan. By the way, I read about this today. يعني you would say, but what does it mean? هيقول لك كده بالظبط. بالظبط. I was expecting that question, so I read about it a little bit. This is authentic hadith, right? Yani this hadith, fi sahih Imam Muslim. He said that these are of the terms, the Shari'i terms, that we have to take it as it is. What does it mean? I don't know. That's what I read, to be honest with you. Fair enough. Yani I came in an authentic hadith, Prophet ﷺ said that, what is the really description of that the sun rises between the two horns of the shaitan? There is not too much description to it, to be honest with you. I'll take it as it is, because I believe in that. Okay? Yani if there is a non-Muslim person, I'm not going to mention the hadith to him, and if I mention the hadith to him, then I have to be, yani, go through the around the hadith to avoid that, because he's not going to believe in that at the end of the day. But alhamdulillah, we believe in that. So this is point, yani, the time number one and number two. وَحِينَ إِذٍ يَسْجُدُ لَهَا الْكُفَّارُ فَإِذَا ارْتَفَعَتْ قَدْرَ رُمْحٍ أَوْ رُمْحَيْنِ فَصَلِّ فَإِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ مَشْهُودَةٌ مَحْضُورَةٌ حَتَّى يَسْتَقِلَّ الرُّمْحُ بِالظِّلِّ. So after the sun rises and these 15 minutes minimum passed, you can pray, and actually it is a very good time for prayer. You guys know the importance of Salat al-Duha. Prophet ﷺ used to pray Salat al-Duha, and it's one of the great sunnah. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in this hadith, that this is a witnessed salah. That this salah is witnessed by the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows, and he's, yani, you are being witnessed while you pray this time. So after the sun gets high, until what? There's a well. Until there is no shade, you stop again. This is number what? Huh? Number three. I'll wait, as the Prophet ﷺ said, ثُمَّ أَقْصَرْ عَنِ الصَّلَاةِ. Stop praying. فَإِنَّهَا تُسَعَّرُ أَوْ تُسَجَّرُ تُسْجَرُ, sorry, تُسْجَرُ جَهَنَّم. Again, another term that the hellfire is foiling at this time with the sun. And people are, the sun worshippers, they pray at that time, by the way. They pray at the sun rises, exactly when the sun rises, at the time of the well at sunset. This is the time that they pray. Alhamdulillah, we don't pray at that time. Okay? فَإِنَّهَا تُسْجَرُ جَهَنَّمْ فَإِذَا فَاءَ الْفَيْءُ. يعني الفيء هو فَإِذَا فَاءَ الْفَيْءُ. أهل اللغة العربية, ليبيا والمغرب وليبيا برضو والجزائر. فَإِذَا فَاءَ الْفَيْءُ. قولي عم قول, say يعني بالإنجليزي. تحدث.
ذهب الظل.
No, جاء الظل. ليس ذهب الظل. So, yeah. فإذا فاء الفيء. It's فاء الفيء. يعني when the ظل, the shadow comes, which is the time of, yeah, يعني اللي هو after صلاة الظهر. خلاص, you start getting, seeing the shade. فإذا جاء الظل فصلي حتى إبا فإن الصلاة مشهودة محضورة حتى تصلي العصر. It's again another good time to pray from that time after the zawal, 20 minutes after the zawal. So you pray Salat al-Dhuhr, and you can pray as much as you can between Salat al-Dhuhr and Salat al-Asr. It's a good time to pray حتى تصلي العصر. فأقصر عن الصلاة. رقم كم كده؟ What's number now?
Four.
After Salat al-Asr, فأقصر عن الصلاة حتى تغرب الشمس. Until the sun sets. فإنها تغرب حين تغرب بين قرني الشيطان. The same as it rises between the horns, or the two horns of the shaitan, it disappears or sits between the two horns of the shaitan. At that time too, number five, don't pray, which is immediately at the sunrise. After the sunrise, we pray Salat al-Duha. Sorry, sits, sorry. وَحِينَئِذٍ يَسْجُدُ لَهَا الْكُفَّارُ. When the sun sets, at the time of sitting, the kuffar, they prostrate to the sun. These are the five times as given in the hadith of the Prophet. What happens is, the ulama, they get the hadith and they said, you know what? Yeah, the Prophet said, don't pray. But is it nafila? Is it the fard? Is it forbidden? Is it just undesirable? Here is came the differences of opinion and the understanding of the ulama from this. And as I said, تَطْلُعُ بَيْنَ قَرْنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. It's يعني a turn. فَإِنَّا تُسْجَرُ جَهَنَّمْ. It's a turn. And يعني many of the opinions about this, يعني whether, as I said earlier, يعني it is forbidden, totally haram, or just undesirable. يعني we will go through the details, but inshallah ta'ala you go home and you read as much as you can about this inshallah ta'ala. طيب. Any question about this before I go to the question number two? تفضل يا أمين.
With regards to the wudu, sometimes not here but in other areas, but basically the time of dhuhr on our timetables, it's set at 1 minute after the zenith, when the sun is at its maximum. According to this description, we should wait longer than 1 minute.
It's 20 minutes. But there is something that we mentioned last week, that the sun here does not go as we say, like عمودية لا تأتي عمودية أبدا أصلا. In this part of the world, the sun doesn't go like that in the time of the zenith. It's a little bit this way. It's not, يعني we're not early anyway. You said that last week, and we mentioned that last week,
but
right?
Zenith in English doesn't mean that you have that it's like that. Zenith means it's the maximum it reaches, even if the maximum is very low. It's still the maximum. That's the zenith.
Wallahi, but then you take us to a different level, man. This is English now.
But even in
بس الزوال يا شيخنا هو this is the way that we translate it into English.
زوال
but يعني معنى كلمة الزوال يعني
يعني disappearance of the shape.
بالضبط.
زوال يعني
yeah, بالضبط. It's not about being high or it's like that. There is no shade at all. But that's the Arabic word. Let's stick to the Arabic now and say that when here it doesn't come like that, it comes like that a little bit, right? To the west.
More like that.
Yeah, more like that, Kamal. If we're okay. We should be okay, inshallah. Okay? Okay.
This is the one when the shams tan tasif al sama,
لا 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 مش كده. No. هو زي ما قال كده انه ليس هناك انما بتبدا الشمس from which part the sun rises from the west.
يعني
I want to wake you up.
يعني here
from the east.
Yes.
هنا كده الايست ولا كده؟
East
كده صح؟ ف comes like that. In the morning you have the shade, right? Comes shade starts like that until it starts. Zawal meaning that shade is gone. And again comes but to me and you, when we say zawal meaning that anna shams amudi. Waqt al-zawal. Allah. Minimum shade for us over here. Yeah, but still, يعني, we don't want to confuse the brothers because if he goes to the books doesn't say what we have here, to be honest with you. Because here is extreme. We're not normal. Not you guys. The weather or the circumstances is not normal over here. Okay, for the Amrin.
Yeah, let's say I wake up 2 minutes before sunrise.
Yeah.
Do I pray sunnah on the fard or
pray? Pray fard right away. Pray fard. Without wudu, without anything. Just catch the salah. Okay? Pray the fard and then pray the sunnah, but you cannot pray the sunnah at the time of that. Sun rises, you have to wait until the shuruq time and then you pray the sunnah.
What's the difference between salat shuruq and salat al-Duhr?
It's the same.
Same.
Yeah. Same time, the same thing, everything. Allah. But salat shuruq تحدد بالركعتين التي أو التي تلي شروط الشمع. وصلاة الضحى بتمد المدة حتى صلاة الإيه؟ الظهر حتى وقت الزوال يعني. ولكن لها واحد لأن الوقت واحد. تفضل.
I thought that we're allowed to pray Doha until about 20 minutes before Dhuhr because that's the entrance of the
Yeah. هو after the زوال you're talking about صلاة الظهر خلاص.
You know, but I'm talking about that half hour here in our country is more like 15-20 minutes before Dhuhr.
Yeah.
Are we still allowed to pray Dhuhr in it, or is it
no,
part
no,
of the
no,
forbidden time? Because you keep saying until Dhuhr, but
I'm sorry. Until the time of Zawal, which is attached to Dhuhr. Right after that, it's Salat al-Dhuhr. Allahu Akbar. So, go ahead, Sheikh Al-Hanan.
Sheikh. According to your speech, you said at the beginning, don't take any hadith unless there is like a proof of it. So, is there any reason behind the why
talking about the reason behind the hadith.
Why, like, the
Prophet? Yeah, the hadith said that. The people, if you're looking about, like, some, about wisdom behind that or the reason behind that. So the Prophet said clearly these are five times, okay? But here is, and the hadith mentioned that at the time when the sun rises, the time when the sun is amuriya, at the zenith, and the time when the sun sets, those kuffar used to pray to the sun at that time.
But those kuffar, they still exist now? Or
Taba. You have Abad al-Shams everywhere. Go to India. They worship everything. Alhamdulillah. There is God, some people, they still worship the sun. Absolutely. But in this time, you cannot say that there is no this or that, the people are smart. No. You have people, maybe you know some people of those people like that, very smart. Physicians, for example, here in North America, very smart. Smart with the very talented physicians from certain country, and they were shipping the cow. And he is one of the unique doctors in this field. You're talking about, I know a person, cardiologist. You know who's cardiologist? Heart doctor. One of the best in his area, in the States. And he worshiped the cow. But when you talk to him, he said, you know what? It's not about that I worship the cow. Just I found my people, they're doing this, I do that. وَجَدْنَا عَلَيْهِ أَبَعَرَ No, but a reason is there, yeah. What the خلاص استيك تو ذا روح في كبد السماء حتى الزوال
مش ده فين حاجه التعريف
لا انا ما قلتش كده احنا قلنا ان الزوال وبعد كده انت بتتكلم في تلتين ساعه رمح او رمحين تلتين تلت ساعه 20 مينت انا من زمان قوي اصلا يعني لونج تايم اجو اي ترايد ماي بيست ان تو ريسيرش ذس اند تو جيت ات ان تايمينج بس البروبلم ذات وين وي كم تو ادمنتن تايمينج از اولويز ديفرنت يعني you say 10 minutes, I said it's half an hour. طب هتعمل ايه؟ It's a normal timing is 10 minutes, 15 minutes after sun rises. And 10 minutes, 20 minutes before Salat al-Dhuhr, if you want to put it this way. And then after Salat al-Asr, it is like, it's longer than this. But try your best to estimate the time.
So you have to look at it in degrees.
Exactly, and it's, man, it's like, so it's science, man.
No, there is a website, you just go and you see how high...
So when he's gonna pray, like he's gonna go to the website, but... Okay, I'm with you. I'm with you 100%.
But...
It's your job. Yani we said that. Might be a little bit confusing for you, but it's still your job to make sure that you're praying on the right time or on the wrong time. Am I allowed to pray at that time or not? Am I allowed to pray the sunnah or the fard at that time or not? So it's your job, it's your homework.
So for instance, the time that we have on the timetable, let's say shorob, this is the time at which the sun's, the peak, we just start seeing some of the sun, not all of it is up.
Yeah.
So between the time you just start seeing a beam of light until the time the full sun is up.
Yeah.
In our countries, it will take 4 or 5 minutes.
Yes. This is.
In here, it will take 12 minutes. And then you have to wait for it to get up to about 2 degrees. Is it a fair?
So to be in the safe side, wait as much as you can after, you know, the sun rises after the shuruq, and then pray the 2 rak'at for the shuruq and start with salat al-duha after that.
So my question is.
For the shuruq.
My question is, the hadith says rumha or rumhain. So say it's 3 meters.
Yeah. Three meters exactly.
But it's 3 meters where? So you're standing up, is it three meters at the horizon? Is it 3 meters versus...
Wallah, you answer this question.
Yeah.
Research it and answer it to us next week, inshallah. And it's a good question, to be honest with you.
Yeah, should we make this complicated? Because...
Okay. So, Amin, next week, will research it and will enlighten us with this, inshallah. Yeah. I'm serious.
No, I researched. I didn't know, so I'm just looking at if the sun is over 2 degrees.
Okay, khalas. Interview next week because I need to research it anyway. Okay. So I'll take some load from me and give it to you. Okay, you do it.
I just notice if the mountain, if you're living close to the mountain could be very high.
Yeah.
And you can't see it.
That's your question. Last week we disagreed on that. My point is that you wait until you abide by the area that you are in, which is higher than the level that you are in. But some other brother said, you know what? We leave that to you. Yeah, here is admitted. Even you go up, it's admitted. You will abide by the time of admitted.
Yeah.
So, I don't know.
I had one question. Some question that's coming up in Arabic, we don't know it. Like, what actually.
Yeah, if it is very important, if it is like something like public, I translate it for sure. Okay. So, you didn't miss a lot.
I just confused what was the question and what was the answer that the brother.
No, because he mentioned something that we didn't talk about it. So I didn't want to confuse the brothers, so I answered in Arabic first.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, so you didn't miss anything. Unless the part that I mentioned in Bengali, if you understand Bengali, that's something else. Sorry, Hakim.
Yeah, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Yeah, basically, in the we're talking about the Makruh time when the sun is yellow till the sun sets.
Yeah.
You can't do it. But in the Hadith,
The hadith here is in Sahih Bukhari, okay? But again, it's a hadith only about the fard. يعني you missed asr. You didn't pray asr. Whether it is qada or you're praying on time, the hadith is telling you it's you're still praying on time. But I cannot pray sunnah.
But that's a different hadith about the sun being yellow is in a different hadith.
Yeah, here is he's talking about the hadith that I mentioned, right?
Yeah,
if you catch, if you catch,
that one doesn't mention.
Yeah, but there is another hadith mentioned the yellow, and we mentioned it last week. But I don't want to like confuse you because you know what? There is something funny. Some of the scholars of the Salaf Salih, they said you can pray anytime and no restrictions. But you know, but there is a hadith. You know, I have to abide by the hadith. That's why. So going different degrees between the haram and makruh is easier and less dangerous than just open it like that. Go ahead.
Yeah. What if I pray Asr prayer and after that can I pray Asr again with Jama?
Good question.
See, you, this is one of the things that Imam Hanbal said that you still can do that even it's time of Qura'ah. You can do that. He mentioned exactly the same example that you give, that you prayed home, okay? And you came just, you know, with the brother and then they're praying the Jama'ah in the masjid. You pray with them.
Exactly.
You
pray with them. This become very common situation in university or
yes. Yeah, you can do that. You can do that, absolutely, you can do that, inshallah.
Some scholars say you can do it for Maghrib because it's 3 rak'ahs and then the total number of prayers during the day it switches from being unpaired to uneven to even. Something like that.
Say it again.
The number should be of rak'ahs in your day should be uneven. So you can do it with any, you can repray Jama'ah for any prayer except for Maghrib. Some say that. It's not, I don't know if it's majority or minority.
I never heard that, but it should be inshallah. In any case, I said that the week before last week, the khutbah before last khutbah. Who remembers what I said exactly about this? That it's one of the etiquettes of Friday that you pray the 2 rak'at. That Sahabi came and sat down, the Prophet said, Tuan, kum fasal. Then Al-Malikiyya, they said no. They take the other hadith, when the Prophet said to that Sahabi when he was over, like stepping over the next, اجلس فقد أذيت وأنيت. You sit down, so they take a different hadith. Why, akhwanna? Why? These are 2 hadith. Ya akhi, their way of getting the hadith was different than you. Now you have Al-Bukhari, Al-Muslim, Sahih, Musnad, Sunan, everything is available. Go to the library over here, everything is there. But their way was different. I got the hadith from this chain of narratives, but I didn't get the other hadith. There was no books for them. So he got this hadith, he followed that hadith. He didn't get the other hadith. It doesn't mean that he ignored the other hadith or he does not believe in the other hadith. No, he didn't get it. That's why he followed this way. That's why it's easier for you and me.
But they gave us a very easy solution.
Exactly. It's for you. Yeah, if you then if the hadith supporting both opinions, khalas, no problem. You have the hadith supporting the opinion that you should pray, and you have the hadith supporting the opinion that you shouldn't pray. Khalas, I will just do what's convenient. Like you come and the imam is like very hot on the member, there's a nice topic, khalas, listen to him, ya'amal, khalas, wa'a. And then you come that the imam is blowing, khalas, salli rak'atim, khalas, pray to rak'at. And you come, there is no space aslan to stand and pray the two rak'at, sit down. There is a space, you come early, pray, khalas. You know what I mean? Faddal ya Misa.
For the sunnah of the Fajr, Abdullah ibn Masud radiallahu, he prayed when the imam started the first salah, he prayed in the outside of the mosque for two sunnah, and he joined. So
what I said is, don't do it because it's not the preponderant opinion, it's not the preferable opinion, and it takes from your like jama'ah with the imam. Why you have another solution, you can pray after. Okay? We're not ignoring the behavior of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, but it's better to go with the jama'ah, and there is another opinion that going different than this. Okay? Type. I don't think that we should go to the second question.
Yeah.
We'll start with it.
Huh? Leave for next week.
Yeah, next week. We'll start with it next week, inshallah ta'ala. This is almost an hour. So inshallah ta'ala, next week we'll start with the places in which we shouldn't pray, along with after that we have two more topics. Hopefully we finish both inshallah ta'ala, the adhan and the iqamah, and the rules of the adhan and the iqamah will be inshallah the topic for next week.
Can I ask off the top one question?
Yeah.
So what do you think about the inshallah.
Go ahead, you can.
I always get confused because there are several opinions that confuse eyes. Like when brothers they recite the Alhamdulillah Surah Fatiha, while the imam is reciting too. So in one thing, yes, he is abiding the hadith that is saying that La Salata like without the praying,
yes,
the recitation, yeah, of the Fatiha.
Yeah.
And also he is missing so many other things, like he's missing the recitation, he's not concentrating of the imam. So I get confused on that. Yeah, there is opinion, but what's the best so everybody can do this?
Wallahi, I'll tell you
something. Sometimes I stand with a brother who is like reading Alhamdulillah too loud that I...
Yes, you don't hear the imam. You don't hear the imam. So the ulama, we said earlier, the differences of opinions amongst the ulama is a mercy for us. Like this situation, if I have somebody next to me, the imam is saying Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, he's saying Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen after him. The imam is saying and he's saying, and the imam is repeating the imam in every word. To me it's going to be annoying, right? And to you it's annoying. While we have other two opinions, absolutely, Imam Hanifa in this opinion is very nice. Qura'atul imam, qura'al ma'mum. As long as the imam is reading loud, you're fine. You don't have to read at all. Imam Shafi'i said a nice opinion too, that you wait until, that's why the imam should give the ma'mum a little gap after he finishes al-fatiha before reading the surah. Give him a little few seconds to read his surah quickly, al-fatiha. Go with one of these two instead of annoying others.
Wait, some people say that's bid'ah because there is no report of the Prophet nor the Sahaba waiting between the reading Fatiha and the surah.
No, that's one of the certified opinion of Imam Shafi'i. It's a win.
No, I know, but that's a criticism of that opinion. That's a common criticism.
I never heard that criticism. I never heard it. But at the end of the day, if somebody's taking an opinion, you cannot. This is one of the things that we agree on. If somebody is following a school of thought, I cannot just go to him and say, you know what, you're doing something wrong. If he is following something that has authentic opinion or hadith. But what's the preferable, what's the most convenient for all of us? It's for sure that I don't annoy others. I'm with you, but you cannot.
I just thought, like sometimes the problem is, the speed is different, right? So the imam might be reading faster, or the guy who's standing beside me, he's still reading the Fatiha, but the imam has even started the surah after the Fatiha, but he's still and like confused between the ma'mum, recitation.
The ma'mum is not even allowed to raise his voice anyway, to loud his voice. So that's a wrong behavior anyway, to be reading loud. If the imam is reading loud, I cannot read loud. I'm not copying the imam, I'm disturbing myself, I'm disturbing others. But this is for everybody. If you want to do it, just at least do it in a way that you don't hear yourself. Wallahu.
Someone said to me that your salah is not complete because you're not following the hadith, la salata bi ghayr al-fatiha.
No. This is wallahu.
And then I got confused with him.
No, you shouldn't
need to. I thought you were annoying me, so.
Yes, Allah a'lam. Any other question? Off topic
question?
Yalla, jazakumullah khairan. We'll see you, inshallah. Salat al-Fajr tomorrow. We have the Tajweed class. And inshallah.
Is there a change in time?
Yeah. Tomorrow, Salat al-Fajr at 5:15, inshallah. Iqama from Salat al-Fajr at 5:15 tomorrow, inshallah. And we'll see you, inshallah, next week for Seerah and Fiqh. Assalamu alaikum.